Welcome to Peace United Church of Christ. Today is Music Sunday, and we are going to need to improvise a little bit today. So you will hear some new music, some music from last year, as well as some that we have on video. So I hope you will enjoy the music and the service. Let us be in worship.
Soon we shall celebrate the birth of Jesus. We worship God with joy in our hearts as we are reminded of the words the angel said on the first Christmas day. Behold, I bring you good news of a great joy which will come to all the people. Reading John 15, verses 9 through 11. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. We relight the first two candles in our Advent wreath, the candles of hope and peace, imagining the future of God's coming kingdom. Happy are those whose hope is in the God of Israel. The voiceless will soon sing for joy. Today we light the third candle, the candle of joy, having joy in knowing that Christ is already with us. We rejoice in God's goodness, knowing that God's promises are true. Like the greening of the land after the winter, the advent of our Savior is assured. Even the descendants shall blossom, full of new life. The world of the Lord endures forever. Joy-filled giver of life, let the anticipation of your birth fill us with overflowing joy. May our excitement and anticipation be a sign to the world that you are always near. Amen.
Call to worship. We are ready, O God, to behold the presence of your Spirit among us. We have come on this journey seeking hope and peace. Justice and peace shall be brought to all God's people. God is fulfilling the ancient promise of a Savior. Join me in the opening prayer. Promised One, we anticipate your arrival with great joy. May this year be the year when the hungry will eat their fill and the oppressed will dance in the newfound freedom, when the powerful will be laid low and the lowly be lifted up. You come to turn our lives upside down, where we consider ourselves better and more deserving than others. Lower us with humility. Where powers rule over our lives, raise us up and set us free. Give us courage to be your justice seekers and peacemakers, not only for ourselves, but for all. Let the power of your love rule within our hearts, and may your peace fill our souls as we joyfully sing your glorious love coming to us anew this Christmas. In your name, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Isaiah 35. The wilderness and the dry land shall be glad. The desert shall rejoice and blossom. Like a crocus, it shall blossom abundantly and rejoice with joy and singing. Strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to those who are fearful of heart, be strong, do not fear. Here is your God who will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened, the ears of the deaf unstopped, and the lame shall leap like deer, and the tongue of the speechless sing for joy. A highway shall be there, and it shall be called the Holy Way. And the ransomed of the Lord shall return, and come to Zion with singing. Everlasting joy shall be upon their heads, and they shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away.
Magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Savior, for he hath regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. For behold, from henceforth all generations shall call me blessed, for he that is mighty hath done to me great things, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on them that fear him, from generation to generation.
Children, you will notice that we just lit the third candle. This is the candle of joy. It's pink because this is Mary's Sunday, and Mary is the mother of Jesus that we celebrate. So the joy candle is the joy of having Mary give birth to Jesus, but it's also what Jesus does for us. There's an old song. I've got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart. And it says, it's down in my heart to stay. And then the next verse is, I've got the love of Jesus down in my heart to stay. Because you see, there's a real difference between happiness and joy. Happiness is fleeting. When things are going good, when we have surprises in our life, we have the feeling of happiness. And sometimes we call that joy, but that's not the joy this candle is talking about. Because we can so easily become sad again. But even when we're sad, we can still have joy because we have the joy at the love of Jesus in our hearts. So no matter what, we know that God always loves us. Jesus loves us, is with us, helping us. Whether it's a good time or a sad time, we can still always have joy. Let us pray. Gracious God, we thank you for the joy that we know in Jesus. And we thank you as we wait for the birth of Jesus that we have that love and that joy within us, even in times of trials. So lift up the joy in our hearts and let us share it with others. Amen. Today we celebrate Mary. Mary the mystic who spoke with an angel. Mary the brave heart who took on the role of God-bearer, who will come to experience both the grief of her son's cross as well as the joy on Easter morning of an empty tomb. Mary, who you called blessed for all generations. Mary, the prophetess, who sang, "My soul magnifies the Lord," as she rejoices with her cousin Elizabeth of older years in the mutual roles that they share of sacred childbearing. Mary, who sings a prophetic song of joy for all God has done in the past and the fulfillment of God's promises and all that God is doing now for the whole of the earth. You know, Luke's Gospels begin like an overture with prophetic songs. It starts with Zechariah's song, which we heard last week, which he sang on the birth of his son, John, the prophet of the Most High, who would prepare the way for God's mighty Savior. And now Mary's song, known as the Magnificat, Latin for magnify, when in part she recites promises of the prophets of old. And her song is a song of resistance against the pain and the sorrow of living under the oppressive, forceful rule of Rome. And it's a song of justice, where the proud and the mighty will be brought down and scattered, and the lowly will be lifted up, and the hungry will be filled with good things. On Christmas Eve, we will hear the chorus of the angels singing to the shepherds, singing, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom God favors." And then will come the Song of Simeon, sung after Jesus' birth, that this child is the light and the salvation promised to the nations. These prophetic songs, sung at the beginning of Luke's gospel, set the stage for the good news for the entire gospel. And Luke continues the importance of singing with joyful songs of praise into the book of Acts as he tells of Paul and Silas singing in prison and how the violent earthquake shook the foundations and they were released from their chains and opened the prison doors. Advent and Christmas is a season when people love to sing. One of my most dearest, cherished memories of Christmas is when my father and myself on Christmas Day sang all the Christmas hymns. He was up in years and no longer really able to hold a long conversation, so I pulled out the hymnal that he knew of old, and we just sang them together. And then we continued for hours, starting with the beginning of the hymnal and moving to the back, singing the hymns. And I cannot tell you of the light of joy that was on my father's face shining that day as he sang with a hearty voice all of the hymns he knew and the joy that he knows in the Lord. When life is good, sing with joy. Rejoice in the goodness of God. And in the words of Paul, rejoice always. Again, I say rejoice. When life is filled with sorrow and grief, sing for joy. Sing for the joy of God's great love, which never fails. Sing when your heart is breaking to remember all God has done for you in the past. And sing with joy now, even if it is a time of sorrow for you, for God covers you with love that is deep and wide. Know that God is with you right now, comforting you, guarding you, supporting you in and through all things. Sing for joy, for all the goodness that God yet desires for your future. And sing for joy because Christ's Spirit is coming to be born in us anew, coming to open new highways and new doors, coming with salvation to transform our lives with grace and with mercy. Coming that we may know the fullness of peace and justice in our world. And coming again to let His Spirit of divine love dwell within our hearts and deep into our souls, assuring us that all is well. So now let us enjoy hearing God's message to us today through the gifts of instrument and song.
came down at Christmas. Love, the lovely, love divine. Love was born at Christmas. Stars and angels gave the sign.
Love came down at Christmas.
Let us be together in prayer. For the beauty and gift of music this morning, O God, we give you thanks. For the joy which comes to our hearts, we are forever grateful. This Advent season is filled with waiting for the day we can hug our family members once more. for the day we can open our church doors and worship in our beloved sanctuary together. For the arrival of vaccines to come with ample supply and administration. And we await the day those who are ill may once again be healthy and whole. So we sing of your faithful, enduring love. We sing for all who long for justice and who wait for hours in lines for food. We sing for all who struggle with finances due to loss of hours or loss of job. We sing for your comfort and healing light to be with Don and Eric and Arlene and Arlene's mother and Michael and Paula and their family and Bruce and Brenda and Amy and Sandy and all who seek wellness and ease in body, mind, and spirit. Keep us singing to lift our spirits, rejoicing and trusting in your love, even if our days know sorrow, grief, or pain. We long for the coming of Christ anew into our lives and for his saving grace, that the woes and the wrongs of humanity may be transformed and your just peace may prevail. We sing for peace in our communities, our nation, on earth. Hear now the silent prayers upon our hearts. May the song of Mary be on our hearts and minds today. May the fulfillment of your promise be made known to us. May our Savior guide and lead us each day so that we may be bearers of his love too. Together now we pray as he taught us to say, Our Creator, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Good morning. Last week, we presented a video of Kathy Barker's testimony to the benefits of the Christmas Fund as she experienced them when she was a child. Her story is just one of many, and I'd like to share another one with you now. The Reverend Jean Taylor was called to ministry in the 1960s and, along with her husband John, spent 33 years jointly serving congregations in Wisconsin, Nebraska, and Iowa. Born with cerebral palsy and diagnosed with moderate to severe hearing loss in the third grade, Jean became a fierce advocate for the church's awareness of and response to those with disabilities. And I quote, there is a hidden cost of disability in which many are unaware, she explains. The financial cost of speech therapy, hearing aids, motorized wheelchairs, specialized computers, all expensive. Without these, isolation and desperation can set in. Jean served with the United Church of Christ's Disabilities Ministry and in other capacities with the National Church, and was instrumental in the conception and funding of the Virginia Cryer Endowment Scholarship Fund, which provides tuition and assistive technology for ministers with disabilities. And quote, I'm grateful for the United Church of Christ being with me on my journey and its essential that the church continue its commitment to clergy who have disabilities. Hearing aids have been a godsend to Jean from the first, since she was in college. They worked well for the time, and I could hear the fire crackle for the first time, and it was just thrilling. After retirement, the high cost of newer technology hearing aids was problematic. A grant from the Christmas Fund filled the gap left by her insurance allowance, allowing Jean to have hearing aids that make all the difference. As a minister, I always ask people to support the Christmas Fund, to support those life work who's serving and empowering others, but I never thought I would be on the receiving end. I am humbled and grateful for the acknowledgement by my church that hearing aids are life-giving. So Jean received assistance through the Christmas Fund, and we will be accepting our collection for the Christmas Fund on December 20th. Please consider a donation for the Christmas Fund this year to assist retired clergy and lay employees of the United Church of Christ. Thank you.
God loves a cheerful giver. As we have received the gift of song today with great joy, let us offer to God our offerings out of gratitude and praise.
Thank you.
offertory prayer. Loving God, we offer these gifts to you with joy. For your gift of Emmanuel, God with us, for the healing of this world. Fill our hearts with greater joy to serve others, so that justice may prevail and peace may reign on earth. In the way of Jesus Christ, amen.
May the joy of the Lord be deep within you. And now may the peace, the hope, the joy, and the love of Christ be with us all. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you.